This tutorial explains the test code that 1. Verifies that our object-oriented model is free of defects, and 2. Proves that the model does not conform to the Liskov substitution principle. In the class diagram, there are a few things to note. For each package in the application, there exists a child package called test that contains a derived test case rooted in the AUnit framework class test fixture. This is the test code, and this is the test fixture. We use fixture instead of standard in this example because we need individual access to the test cases rectangle.test and square.test. The test case class for shape contains an attribute that points to the unit under test. Initial conditions cause this attribute to connect shape.test to shape. Although not shown in the diagram, it is worth noting at this point that setup is overridden in rectangle.test to set the unit under test attribute to rectangle. The same applies in square.test for testing square. Code implemented in shape.test to test shape is inherited by rectangle.test to test rectangle, which inherits from shape, and so on. In other words, we can apply tests that we did not write. Inheritance therefore provides another mechanism in Ada to allow for code reuse. Now let's look at the code. The shape test case is of type test fixture and contains the attribute unit under test, which initially points to the shape class. The shape test case declares three primitive operations. Here we set a width and read back the value to confirm. And do it again for another value. Note the use of the object.method syntax and that dispatching methods can be highlighted as is done here. Here we do the same thing as above, but for height. Rectangle.test, we see that rectangle inherits from shape. Setup is needed, and there is only one non-inherited operation to write a test for. Rectangle type is declared in the parent package, that is in rectangle. Because we need to take an access from the variable, it must be in memory, i.e. not in a register. We communicate this requirement to the compiler using the alias keyword. It also serves to remind the reader that the variable is referenced by pointers. Unlike Java, pointers in Ada are explicit. Here we establish a connection to the rectangle. Now that we have access to the rectangle, we can write a test for area. So we set the width to 3, we set the height to 5, and we expect the area to be 3 times 5 or 15. And here's our call to the unit under test to get the actual value. Here we initiate a rectangle caller package using the test case, allocate a place in memory for the test suite, and also for each scenario in the test case. In this section, we create a concrete test case scenario for each test reference. This is an inherited test, as is set height, and here's our local test. And here we add the test to the suite. In square.test, square is derived from rectangle, setup is needed, and square has its own test for area. Here we establish a connection to the square, and we perform a test get area. For a square, of course, we set a side to 3, in this case width, area will be 9. Set the other side, height, to 5, area should be 25. The same pattern is applied here as for the rectangle case. Now the objective in this suite is to show that a rectangle and a square are not interchangeable with regards to area. To prove this, we effectively pass a square, posing as a rectangle, to the method testGetArea on the rectangle test case and observe that it fails. To set up this experiment, we need individual access to scenarios on both the square test case and the rectangle test case. Therefore, we instantiate two callers in this package. Square caller and rectangle caller. Here we instantiate a function to replace a square test case scenario method with a rectangle test case scenario method. So we effectively perform a bit copy from the source to the target. In this section, we create tests in which a square scenario is replaced by a rectangle scenario. Well, the width should be interchangeable, and the height likewise, but the method to test area will fail. Note that the rectangle.test GetArea method applied to a square causes the height and width attributes in the square to be equal. The rectangle test case scenario expects area to be equal to height times width. So when the actual value of area is returned as width squared, the assertion fails, thereby proving that a square is not a rectangle with regards to area. Yes, here we compose a suite of test suites. Harness has been explained in previous tutorials. So here's the output from the run. And we see that our object model behaves as it should while these tests pass. And in the case of Liskov test, the set width worked, as did the height, but the test area failed. And as a final check, we do a coverage report to make sure that all the code in the unit under test was covered. That's what this test shows. All right, this concludes the Liskov substitution principle tutorial.